Hey you guys, it is Casey. This video is aimed at students who are looking to transfer to UT Health for nursing after their time here at SAC. So I wanted to, in case I did not get a chance to meet with you all, I think I've met with many of you, but just in case, review a couple of, I guess, rules of thumb to remember regarding UT Health, okay? So real quick, you know, for those of you who have not visited the website, I would definitely recommend that you do. All I ever do is just Google, you know, UT Health, nursing, prerequisite classes, and they will pull up a list of all of the classes that you need. So it does total, looks like, to 60 hours. It's slightly different than the associate's degree that we offer here at SAC. So I'll also point out those differences. But again, real quick, just so that way you kind of know what to think about, or the important things to be thinking about. Rule one is simply that all math and science courses need to be completed by the application deadline. And you can reference undergraduate admissions to kind of, you know, read through. It's definitely important to look through this. Right, it has information regarding the TEAS exam that you'll need to take, things like that. It has the application deadlines on here. Right, December 15th if you were going to try to do an accelerated program, August 1st for a spring entry, and February 1st for a fall entry. So, you know, here is where you'll read about needing to have all math and science classes done before the deadline. And there should also be something on here about needing to complete, here we go, 51 of the 60 semester hours also by that application deadline. Okay, so what that means is that your final spring semester that you're here at SAC, only 9 hours can be done that semester if you're doing a traditional, you know, 2 years here. That would be on that prerequisite list that we were just looking at. So let me go back to that, okay? Other than that, right, the second thing to keep in mind, well, I guess I've reviewed both of them, okay? So again, that was that all math and science need to be done before you apply. So if you were looking to start in fall of 19, all those math and science classes have to be done by next fall. You cannot do any in spring, okay? Then also, again, only 9 hours out of the 60 that they're requiring can be done also in that spring term, okay? So that way you kind of can see the difference. This core 90, that's something that only SAC needs, and the speech 1311 is only something SAC needs. So we pretty much planned that out, right? History, government, sociology, they don't have to be these exact courses, but again, you can find that list here of everything that you're going to need for UT Health, okay? Some other things I'm going to point out. Notice that in this example, the student had already done two of those math and sciences their first semester. So that is what kind of gave them a really good jump start and enabled them to get another, you know, here they have the Chem 1405 and Biology 2402, and then here a Chem and a Bio, and here a Math and a Bio. Okay, so that makes the 8. If you did not start off with 2 your first semester, realize that at some point you're going to have to do 3. And if you notice, right, this student has also piled on 5 classes in their fall semester. So you can see by just glancing at this that it's very fast-paced and heavily weighted in terms of how many hours the student is doing each term. Some quick things to also know is that that Chemistry 1405 is a prerequisite for Biology 1322, so you cannot put Biology before Chem. And then Chem 1405 is a prerequisite for Biology 2420, which is Microbiology, okay? So you got to take Chem 1 before you can do Micro, and then you have to do also Chem before you can do Nutrition, which is that Biology 1322. Okay? Scrolling down, I'm going to talk real briefly about the three-year plan. Okay, so let's say you realize, hey, maybe you have a developmental math that you had to do before getting into college algebra, the 13-14. And so you realize there's no way I'm going to finish all of this in 2 years. I'm going to have to stretch it out into three. That's perfectly fine. We have a lot of students doing that as well. If you do that, you just may find yourself having to do a couple of electives, okay? In this version, I highlighted the honors capstone class and, again, the speech as a SAC-only courses. You'd need those, again, for the associates, not for UT Health. So if you look at it this way, you're doing at least two math and sciences, only a couple of semesters. Here I have it in spring of 18 and in fall of 19, and then one bio in each of the fall of 18 and spring of 19, okay? So these are just some examples that you guys can look at. And again, the main thing I wanted to emphasize in this video is that, again, all math and science have to be done before you apply, and that 51 of the 60 hours, which their 60 hours is a little bit different than ours, have to be completed also by that application deadline. Your final spring term that you're here, you will not be doing any math and science, and you will have a maximum of 9 hours from this list of classes right here, okay? So keep those things in mind as you guys are finding the classes you need for spring. I don't want anyone to be surprised. We have had some students in the past who didn't realize those rules. And so when they tried to apply, they realized like, oh man, I still have like one biology class to do or one math class to do. And so it puts them waiting an entire extra semester or sometimes even a year, depending on when they apply. So don't want that to happen to you guys. If you have any questions, feel free to email me or set up an appointment.